Hey, this is Mike from GoCellPhoneRepair.com, and today I'm going to be taking a look at the Kaisi, I believe that's a correct pronunciation, Kaisi iPhone 4, iPhone 4S opening tool set. Now, I realize that the iPhone 4 and 4S are a little bit old at this point, but they do actually make these kits for the 5 and 5S. However, I don't really think you need all of this to do an iPhone 5 because they're so much simpler nowadays. So, you can find them if you want to, but for those of you who are in the business, if you're working on iPhone 4s, 4s's, and you just started out, it's really nice to have something like this to keep you organized, because we've got about a total of, I think, 33 screws on the inside of the iPhone 4, so to keep track of these can be challenging for a lot of people when they're brand new. So if you haven't got your screw organization down, this will help you out a lot, not to mention the fact that they're very inexpensive at this point. They've been out for so long that I actually found this one online today for $5, and you get a lot with it. I'm going to show you here in just a second. Now, the first thing that I noticed about this is the packaging. You know, again, not expecting a lot for $5, but they've actually obscured the description here on the front packaging with the way it's designed. So you have this nice molded fit where everything sits in here, although you can see the triangle tools kind of shifted around a little bit, not a big deal, but they've actually kind of overlooked the fact that you're gonna have a title back here. Maybe they added this stuff later and had to move it up. I don't know what happened, but no big deal. It's functionality-wise, it should still be fine. It's also interesting that they have this little blade right here. If you see this black piece, I couldn't figure out what that was and I had to go to the back. And if you read the description here, this says protective film tool. So it looks like they actually gave you a little squeegee looking thing so that you can smooth out lens protector after you apply it on the phone. So we'll have to take a look at that also in just a second. It's interesting to me as well that they call the triangle pry tools boot tools. I'm not sure why. Could be a European thing. Maybe that's a descriptive term that they use for these. Here we call them guitar picks or triangle tools, but whatever. Makes not much of a difference as far as we're concerned. The funny thing to me is that they call these little blue things, and you'll see I refer to these as pop connector tools because that's about all they're good for. They call these crowbars, which is really funny. If you want to talk about exaggerating, you're not going to pry much of anything with these before the tips are gone. I realize that they are designed just to open up a very small gap between the surfaces that you're prying on. I have used these before to open up an iPod Classic. They can work, but for the most part, they're just much better tools available. Again, this is coming free with the kit, so I'm not going to be too critical of it, but I always laugh when I see these because they're just not good for very many things, especially if you're not familiar with them and you don't know how exactly to use them. But hey, you know what? At least they didn't put a suction cup in here. That would have been even funnier. I get iPhone 4 kits coming in and they give you a suction cup. I have no idea why. You're not going to take anything off of an iPhone 4 with a suction cup. Anyways, we have a couple of, actually three different drivers on the inside. We've got a Phillips and we've got two pentalobe drivers. Now, the interesting thing here is that they have included a 0.8 millimeter pentalobe, also known as a P1 or a TS1, which I don't like calling that TS1 because a lot of people get confused between that and a Torx bit, but they've also included a 1.2 pentalobe, which is used typically on a MacBook. So I'm not sure why they put that in there. You've got an iPhone 4 kit. You're not going to use a 1.2 pentalobe, but hey, you get a free driver out of the deal, so who's complaining? Also, with the Phillips, we typically use a 000 PH 000 or PH 00, but apparently that's not a thing in China, so which I believe is where, yeah, this is where it's manufactured, was China. So they use 1.2 millimeter, which is, I'm going to guess, probably a 000, but either one will work for the iPhone 4. And let's take a look at the inside. Oh, so there is one other thing. Right here, it's kind of hard to see in the light, but if you look just right, it says that this tool is used to remove the screen from the phone. So we'll get a chance to see if that's actually going to work or not. So go ahead and slide this off the back. And yeah, that's interesting. So they cover that up also for whatever reasons. Strange design on the packaging. And I think the easiest way to do this is if we flip it over and we just lift this off, this stuff will probably go. Yeah, there we go. Got it all in one piece. So here we have our two crowbars, if you want to call them that. Again, not good for a whole lot other than removing pop connectors. You might find something else you can do with it. These triangle tools, a little strange. that they included them. You do some prying along the bottom edge and the top edge of the iPhone 4 when you open it, but typically these are a little bit too thick to get in there, so I don't know about this. We'll see how that works out. I'll usually use an iSesimo and then a very thin guitar pick, or about a medium-sized guitar pick like this will usually do the trick a lot better because you don't have that triangular edge that's going to put stress on the glass. So that one looks like it's pretty thin, but again, the fact that it points this direction, it gets wider as you go towards the center, is sometimes a problem. It's easier to crack the glass with that, so I'm not really a big fan of those. Here we have our little lens protector kit. I suppose if you installed a lens protector, you could use this to smooth out the bubbles. It's about the same as a credit card. Well, not going to complain and get a free putty knife out of the deal, if nothing else. What I'm interested to see is how well this is going to work, because it is plastic, but it's somewhat flexible, so maybe we can get underneath here without breaking it. We'll see that in just a second. Actually trying out a new tool that I got today, just to see if it works. And what we want to do is get down here inside the bottom, in between the plastic and the metal, and just like I thought, this is probably not going to do the trick. Yeah, pretty much worthless. So what they suggest is using these, and again, these tools I never find to be helpful for very much, although did actually manage to open it this time, again, probably because this phone has been disassembled before, but and if I was able to start it at that point, then I could switch over to this one. Let's see, let's try that again. So if we go in here, if we're able to get it separated that much, then we can shift over to the other tool, side that I didn't bend yet, and continue prying. Again, remember, we're only going to pry down here at the bottom. And of course, the best part of all is this right here, because as you know, with all the screws on the iPhone 4, it's nice to be able to have something to organize them. If you're not using a magnetic mat or a cloth, or you just haven't got to the point where you feel comfortable with that yet, this is going to do the trick for you, because as you disassemble the phone, you can actually take each screw. Let's see if we can get in here. It's a little tough behind the camera to see where my screws are. And once we get this out, we'll take this and set it exactly where it came out of the phone, which is what these little screws at the bottom are for. So if you lay the phone down from this side, because we're going to go in through the back, they'll show you where everything's laid out, I believe. Let's see. All right, so once we take the panel off, it looks like we've got, looks like I'm missing a screw here. So it looks like that's what they did. We've got, you can see you've got your two screws here for this little retaining clip. Let's zoom in a bit, if possible. Tell you, there we go. All right, so you'll see we've got our screw for our battery terminal would go here, and then we've got these two screws that are going to go in here, and so forth. And they've even gone as far as to give you the outer screws. Now, we do have two here for the vibrating motor, but they've also got the outer screw set. So if you need to go a little bit further, do your volume controls, power button, you can literally strip the phone down to nothing, and you'll be able to lay out the screws, and when you're done, you can just go back and pick them up. Have to magnetize a little bit, but this will help keep you organized. Again, as long as nobody knocks your table around at all. However, this is not magnetic, it is plastic, so it's not really going to hold there. If you turn it upside down, they're definitely going to fall out. I'm just a little interested to see if a magnetic mat would make any difference whatsoever, and it doesn't look like it does. So even if you've got a magnetic mat underneath this plastic, it's not going to do much for you. This will be helpful, but again, make sure nobody hits the table, otherwise your screws are going to go flying all over the place.
If you found the video helpful, hit the like button, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and follow me on Twitter or Facebook. Post your questions in the comment section below or visit gocellphonerepair.com/forum. Thanks for watching.